Hello and welcome to the HandyCam Quick Start Tutorial. I'm Matthew from Plugin Everything, and jumping straight in, I'm going to give you guys a brief overview of each of the controls in HandyCam, and then discuss a couple of gotchas you've got to be aware of while you're using it. Starting straight up with the first thing you should do whenever you are using HandyCam is you aren't going to have an already set up controller. You want to apply the HandyCam controller, the effect, and then hit this setup button. That will create a camera and a controller for you with all of your settings there and apply the expressions. Please make sure you hit that setup button before doing anything else. Once that's done, you're ready to go. Starting with the orbit controls at the top here, they're very similar to Multi's camera rig, just with more math and less layers and a little bit more dynamic. You can see here in this comp that we can orbit around a point in 3D space, like so. And if I untag these layers and remove their expressions, I can manually set the orbit. Currently, X and Y only affect the position, with Z affecting the rotation, like so. Just makes things a little bit more intuitive to how you'd sort of imagine. The advantage of this system is that it's very easy to use and sets up like that. In the advanced, there's this rotation order. I'm not going to jump into detail about this. If you don't understand what I mean when I talk about gimbal lock and rotation order, then you probably shouldn't touch this controller. And it's a very complicated subject that will take up way longer than this video should be to get into. But you can specify whether or not you want it to rotate in Y, X, then Z, which is the standard or the current default method, or X, then Y, then Z. Next up, we're jumping into the look at section over here. You can see I've got a new scene, and if I drag the timeline along, you can see it is always looking at this little orange dot. The look at controller does exactly what it says on the tin. You specify a target, one of the layers here, trims paths for example, and it will always make sure that your camera, no matter where it is in space, is looking in the direction of that object. The offset allows you to set the target offset. So if we jump in here to quite close, you can see it's looking at roughly that center point. However, if the offset is set to 0 and 0, it's not quite looking at the center. And the reason that is because it looks at the layer's origin point, which this layer is this one right here. So to get it to look at the center, we offset and bring it a little bit this way. These controls work in world space, not relative space, and basically allow you to just offset the look at attribute so that you are looking up somewhere else, whether or not it's the center of the layer or whatever. The track button here allows you to look, basically allows you to move inwards and outwards from the direction that you are looking. This works no matter which way you're looking, whether or not you've specified the orbits, the look at target, which you can set to none, the actual rotations in the camera here, which you can utilize if you want. It will calculate all of those and always make sure this track here moves you in and out from the direction that you are looking, regardless of which way you are looking. There's a lot of cool math behind that, by the way. Jumping into the position section over here, position offset is different from the look at offset found here. Look at offset offsets the position that is being grabbed here, so that you basically changes the way the camera looks. Position offset sets the camera's position in relation to this right here. So right now the camera's position offset is 0, 0, and negative 6,000. That means that its local position is in relation to this 0, 0, negative 6,000. I can change this by increasing the X or the Y, which basically moves my camera up or down, once again, in relative position to this. Moving the camera around, you can also just use this. Effectively think of the camera as a child of this HandyCam controller and this position offset as the camera's relative position. The advantage of doing it the way that we've done allows you to do a lot more cool orbity stuff. But that's just in case you're confused the difference between the offset here and the position offset. Once again, position offset is in world space, but it is applied before the orbits are. So if I set all of these to 0, it's looking directly forwards in the 3D space. If I change the Z, it moves in and out. But the same happens if I change the orbits and then alter the Z, it moves in and out. Now understand, this is different from it from this track here. The track moves you in the direction you were looking. Z moves you towards or away from your HandyCam controller. And that is, once again, before the orbits are applied. Jumping to the lens settings, you can control all the standard depth of field settings that you're probably used to. Enable or disable. The aperture, the blur level, focus offset. This focus offset is applied when you set this focus layer. So much like the target layer set up here in look at, focus layer basically makes sure it calculates the distance between your camera and the layer that you want to focus at, and makes sure that the focal length is set, or the focus point, sorry, is set to the right distance to make sure that layer is always in focus. So to give you an idea of what I'm referring to, it means that I can take this right here and move it away, and you can see that this point right here is always in focus no matter where we are. Allowing you to keep track better than any second AC ever could. And the focus offset, much like the position offset, offsets that focus like so from your position, allowing you to get just right the perfect focus. Also, you can set it to none, which means that it's not going to calculate any changes, and you can just simply manually set the focus distance as you normally would. Focal length is the, well, focal length of the camera. Currently, it's in isometric, so it's a 5,000mm lens, but you can set it to a standard 50mm lens if you want. Everything's really small in this particular comp, so a bit hard to show exactly what I'm referring to there, but the focal length affects, like what you'd imagine, the millimeter of the lens, except all in one nice tidy little control without having to mess around with double clicking on here and going into everything in here. Dolly zoom is a great little tick box that basically says everything in the scene stays in the scene, or the frame, sorry. So focal length can still be adjusted like so, but everything stays in the scene as much as it should, very much like those interesting pictures you see online where they've taken multiple pictures from different distances with different, you know, millimeter lens. Yeah, as you can see, a lot of the other settings have been removed, and that is because they're not compatible with Dolly Zoom. Jumping into the wiggle section, you have basically the ability to quite easily create the handheld look, like seen here in this particular shot. I'm just going to scrub through the timeline. So you can control the amplitude and frequency of the focus, and the handheld will control the position. The orbit isn't affected by that, and that's position in relation to after all these orbits are affected. Kind of hard to explain, but you get the idea once you start using it. So very easily, once again, you can get this nice little handheld look that alters that. The amplitude handheld also will affect the X and Y positions of the camera more than the Z, and that is in relative. So when you are using a camera in handheld mode, you'll notice you very rarely move in and out, but you much more often move left, right, and up and down. So the wiggle amplitude handheld here will affect how much you move, or how much the camera moves up, down, left, and right more than inwards and outwards to get more of that natural look, and that is calculated in the direction you were looking. So it is relative to the camera's orientation and not relative to world space. That amount sums up all the controls that you have the ability to use, but there's also these utility functions here that I want to go over. Refresh expressions does basically exactly what you would imagine. You click it and it refreshes the expressions on this HandyCam controller that you can see here in case you screwed something up or a bug happened or whatever else. Bake expressions is a fun one. It will remove the expressions and apply a crap ton of keyframes all across your comp area. Understand, this is this working area here. So if it's only small, it'll only apply to this. You can use this and then remove the expressions or the effect to do things like render on a render farm without having to actually have the HandyCam effect that acts as a user interface installed at all. To unbake, you either hit Control Z or remove the keyframes, as due to limitations of After Effects, we can't have an unbake button. It's also a little bit hard to unbake a cake, as some of you may know. Now onto the gotchas. Fortunately, HandyCam only has the one gotcha at the moment, and that is duplicating the rig. If I was to select the two of these and hit Control D, it looks like it worked, but it didn't. None of the expressions have been tied correctly, and some of the in-between options haven't been tied correctly either. What you instead want to do is select the HandyCam controller and hit this duplicate rig button. That will give you another HandyCam rig that is set up properly.
I just wanted to jump in and mention that if we duplicate a composition, the HandyCam is not going to be linked correctly. Things like the expression will work, however the utilities won't. We'll get this error, couldn't find HandyCam camera. Click setup to create a new one. To fix that, we simply delete the camera and then click setup, and then we're back to normal. Don't worry, you haven't lost any hard work. All the animation and keyframes, all the work that you've done is stored on the HandyCam controller. The camera itself doesn't matter. It's just linking via expressions. So when we hit setup and we created a new camera, the scene is going to be exactly the same. It's just that it's going to be linked correctly, and now we can bake and duplicate and refresh. There'll be no issue.
HandyCam is designed to be pretty intuitive and easy to use. It's a replacement, in case you couldn't tell, for Multi's camera rig, but with a little less bulk to it. In case you hadn't noticed, also, it is only the two layers. All mathematics for the controls, positions, and everything else is completely done programmatically and not through several different parented nodes. This gives you a lot more freedom and a lot more control over everything. I hope you guys enjoy all the fun camera stuff you can do, and let us know if you have any suggestions or queries or whatever else. Thanks for watching. Enjoy.